Mr. Chairman, I yield myself such time as I may consume.
The gentleman's recognized.
Mr. Chairman, America's economic recovery remains sluggish, with the national unemployment rate above 8% for over 40 months. The President promised that his $800 billion spending bill would keep unemployment under 8%. Instead, the spending bill only added to the deficit, which has doubled under this administration. More than 12 million Americans are out of work, 700,000 more than when President Obama took office. And the median income of American families has dropped, too. The President's economic policies have failed, and his regulatory policies have made the economy worse. A recent Gallup poll found that among the 85% of U.S. small businesses that are not hiring, nearly half cited being worried about new government regulations as the reason. President Obama has turned America into a regulation nation. A Heritage Foundation study found that in his first 3 years in office, President Obama implemented 106 major rules that impose $46 billion in additional annual regulatory cost on the private sector. That's a new record. The President promised in his 2011 State of the Union address to fix rules that put an unnecessary burden on businesses, but he has gone in the opposite direction. We need to encourage businesses to expand, not tie them up with red tape. Today, Congress continues to fight the constricting red tape that comes from Washington by offering common sense solutions that deserve bipartisan support, and that's what we do today. Members of the Judiciary Committee introduced three of the titles in the Red Tape Reduction in Small Business Job Creation Act. Mr. Griffin's Regulatory Freeze for Jobs Act gives small businesses a much-needed break from new regulations that cost the economy $100 billion or more until the unemployment rate stabilizes at 6%. The Freeze Act is narrowly tailored to stop unnecessary, economically significant regulations. It contains reasonable exceptions, such as health and safety, criminal or civil rights laws, trade agreements, and national security. The Freeze Act gives job creators confidence about future regulatory conditions, which will encourage them to make the investments that will jumpstart our economy. The RAPID Act, introduced by Mr. Ross, helps to create jobs as it streamlines the federal environmental review and permitting process. It draws upon established definitions and concepts from existing regulations and even from the administration's own recommendations. Employers and investors can't move forward without necessary permits and without confidence in the process. The RAPID Act establishes reasonable, predictable deadlines for agencies to complete the permit review process and for lawsuits to be filed afterwards. The Sunshine for Regulatory Decrees and Settlements Act, introduced by Mr. Quayle, ends the abuse of consent decrees and settlements to require more regulations. For many years, regulatory advocates and agencies have used consent decrees and settlements to establish new rules in secrecy outside the regular rulemaking procedures that provide for transparency and public participation. The sue and settle approach has enabled agencies to impose higher costs and avoid accountability since they can claim, quote, "the court made us do it." Mr. Quayle's legislation makes sure that the public and those affected by regulations have a say in these decrees and settlements. It also requires greater judicial scrutiny and helps prevent an outgoing administration from unfairly setting its successor's agenda through consent decrees. These and all of the titles of the Red Tape Reduction in Small Business Job Creation Act provided needed relief to small businesses. Economic growth depends on job creators, not federal regulators. This legislation frees up businesses to spend more, invest more, and produce more in order to create more jobs for American workers. I urge my colleagues to support this common sense bill, and Mr. Chairman, I'll reserve the balance of my time.
The gentleman reserves. The gentleman from Michigan, Mr. Conyers,
Mr. Speaker.
Is recognized.